What's up, guys? Here we are back on Wind Chaser. Field 15, just hammering away at Sunflower again. So, updated the texture, the crop texture, and residue again. Something I actually pretty happy with now. Got the dirt functioning, or the mud, I should say. Works pretty well. Finished up 18, 17, and 29 with course play. And we're coming up to our second to last field of Sunflower. Technically we have fuel there, but it's all the same, field 10. Yields are doing very well. Anywhere from 60 to 70 bushel an acre. T660, as you can see, it's pretty dirty. So I think what we'll do is we'll just come in here for now and up this door. And we'll just wash this thing down because we went in some mud earlier, and it gets pretty dirty when you're in that mud, so it's pretty cool. I'll show you guys. Mud's all about. It's pretty much just messing around with it today, so it wouldn't, with the wheel lanes was kind of like if you drove over it, it would disappear, so it's kind of updated the dirt fruit so it wouldn't disappear, and basically just change the cut state to cut state 10, the same cut state of defoliated like potatoes and sugar beets, because that doesn't get ruined, and that seemed to do the trick. So as you see, our rig is nice and clean. We have the T9-450 hooked up to the 50-foot disc, and T8 to the DN. I was going to start broadcasting nutrients and cultivating, but I think I'll do that next week after I'm done harvesting, so I don't have to worry about so much going on and refilling and changing out nutrients and stuff like that. So I figured I was just going to focus on harvesting this week with course play and is actually pretty cool. some mud down here on these back roads here. Kind of smoothed out this field a little bit, so it wasn't such a basically like a valley. Anyways, the fruit you just painted in, or the mud you painted in, and it operates off of a couple of LUA files, just like you're painting anything else. The mud itself is really cool, so you can go in and your tires will all of a sudden, you can see how quick it gets dirty, but you can see the tires are spinning and it's just kind of sunken down. It's got kind of like a wave effect to it, and then same thing for the trailers in the back. So you see how crazy dirty it is now. It's actually pretty easy to get stuck. I'm not really happy with how quickly it gets dirty, so I think I'm going to reduce that by like 1,000%. So it doesn't get instantly dirty. Anyways, this is the field that we just harvested, 29 and 17, and then I have some mud on this trail coming up here that is on a hill, and it's pretty easy to get stuck here, even with differentials and stuff like that. You just give it hell, gun it. Tried climbing up this hill with fully loaded trailers. Oh. We're good. So it's pretty cool little scripting that the guys did. Definitely could use a little bit of fine tuning, but anyways, I guess we'll get back to grain car driver. It runs off of the real train mod, and it kind of just what it does is it kind of cycles through wheel radiuses, kind of like increases and decreases the wheel radius. That's how you get that kind of funky like rough field. So basically, like, it increases it by like 0.5, reduces it by 0.2, just, you know, random kind of sequencing. So that's why it kind of has that different kind of movement like that. So that can also be adjusted, so it's not so wild. But overall, I'm pretty happy with it. And T97's doing an amazing job on the grain cart. Yield is very, very good. So I'm actually gonna go and we're at field 15. We're at 7.0. 86.65. So we had something very similar, and we were yielding 74. These guys down here, 7 and 5, they were both 68.67. So this is going to equal. Equal 5 for now. I'm liking this sunflower texture quite a bit better than the old one. It doesn't look as dead. So after this, we'll probably move on to corn. Got a lot of corn planted, but it's all in just a couple fields, so some really big fields. So it'll probably be some nice fields to put the grain cart on course play as well. Because they're pretty big, squarey looking fields. Although I don't really trust course play with grain cart because it goes right through crops. And another reason why I kind of like held out putting down nutrients and tillage because I don't really have the money for the nutrients at this point. I mean, I could take out a loan and kind of like prorate it, but hopefully in the next week, or the end of this week, we got some great demands. Otherwise, if we don't have any great demands in the forecast, I'll probably end up just taking out a couple, 10,000, a couple $50,000-$60,000 loan. Help pay for the nutrients so we can till that in and get the most value for our money. I think we had the most acres planted of sunflowers, so go too bad if you have two 12 rows going, but if we had dual 16s, that would make the job go a lot quicker. It's probably the next thing on the wish list. Anyways, just a little bit more of sunflower. The next video will probably be some corn. So hope that you guys like a little mud action and a little harvesting. So thanks for watching.